Hi, this is the introduction of XPS data analysis. This is the schematic diagram of our end station at the beamline 3.2 UA. The synchrotron coming from the left hand side, passing through the goal mesh to monitor the photon flux coming into the sample. Sample mounted on the ground and monitor drain current. How many electrons coming out we can monitor. We call total electron yield. We can also analyze the energy of electron emitted from the sample in electron energy analyzer. We call XPS station. We have CRAM2 electron energy analyzer. XPS station also can be measured fluorescent yield for X-ray absorption spectrum by MCB and silicon drift detector. Behind XPS, we have angle reserve photoemission electron energy analyzer. We call ARPES station. The sample mounted on cryostat manipulator to cool down the sample down to 5 Kelvin. From the room temperature. We have R4000 electron energy analyzer with energy with high electron energy and momentum resolution. XPS station we have S polarized configuration. However, we have ARPES station with P polarized configuration. This is a schematic diagram of electron energy analyzer. Electron passing through the lens come to hemispherical electron energy analyzer to analyze the energy of electron and momentum. Since XPS was invented, many researchers study energy of electron in each atom and each orbit. Theory also back up to support the energy of electron in the atom, well database in the website, everyone can be see the binding energy plot as a function of atomic number. Each electron orbit show different binding energy, so you can identify the atomic element from the XPS data. You can also consider which electron orbit is appropriate depending on the flux of photon. For example, beamline 3.2 UA provide the photon energy up to 1000. However, beamline provide much higher intensity of photon below 100 electron volt. So XPS and X-ray absorption can be available in this range, and much better result we can obtain below 100 electron volt. When we measure the XPS spectrum, there is not very simple, like carbon 1s, 284 electron volt, but the spectra has broadening. Because of the light beamline, electron optics at electron energy analyzer has a finite broadening effect in energy and spatial resolution. This is also true in the standalone XPS. X-ray source and electron energy analyzer has resolution limited. So we have seen the peak broad depend on the setting of each optics. The XPS itself also has natural width because each electron excited has a finite lifetime depend on the binding energy. Higher binding energy, short lifetime, because excited state come to the ground state very quickly. If you have lower binding energy, you have longer short lifetime, so you can get much sharper peak. In such a way that XPS spectra is not like a delta function. We have seen the Gaussian and Lorentzian shape. Due to the instrumental broadening or sample temperature effect, or lifetime broadening, collision broadening, come to the Lorentzian contribution. The realistic XPS spectra has a convolution between the Gaussian and Lorentzian. So if you have a, if you know the instrumental broadening and lifetime broadening effect, you can deconvolute each contribution, so you can analyze the peak well. For example, you have seen the single peak in XPS. If you know the peak width for natural width and the instrumental resolution, you can actually deconvolute the peak, how many peak inside that single peak. If you see the asymmetric peak shape in the XPS spectrum, you have to see the background effect. Then you can analyze the peak after the background subtraction process. XPS well-known background. We have three basic background functions. When you quantize the atomic element in your sample, you have to know the sensitivity factor for each atomic element and each atomic orbit. We call photoionization cross-section database available online. You know that the standard XPS show the sensitivity factor well known. However, beamline can vary the photo energy to measure the XPS spectrum. Sensitivity factor also depends on the photo energy, so you have to normalize the sensitivity factor for each XPS spectrum. XPS peak appears as doublet some case, except the S electron orbit. Because of the spin, electron spin coupled with the orbital moment, we call spin orbit coupling. Doublet two peaks has constant amplitude ratio depending on the orbital quantum number, and the peak difference energy is also constant based on the spin orbit splitting. This is the inspection survey scan of XPS spectrum. You may see that OJ peak in the XPS because this is also depend on the relaxation process after the ionization of electron. If you have multiple atomic elements in your sample, you may see the OJ overlap with the XPS spectrum. So you have to be carefully choose the photo energy appropriate for your sample. You may also see the large background effect at lower kinetic energy of the spectrum, so you have to carefully choose which background shape appropriate before the peak analysis. XPS is very surface sensitive because electron mean free path quite short. XPS and OJ is limited kinetic energy depending on the soft X-ray energy, and the mean free path is typically less than 10 angstrom. That means we are seeing the XPS spectra and atomic element just below the surface. As we can see that many factors we have to be considered before XPS data analysis. Even also many analytical software available, you have no perfect software available, and you have to pay a lot of money for data analysis sometime. We also have free of charge program available online. I also developed one of the XPS macro on Excel. Everyone has Excel, and we can provide the database and fitting function. We can proceed the XPS data analysis on your laptop. After this session, I would like to introduce the XPS macro.